Welcome to the lecture in the subject structural analysis. Now, in the last three lectures, 71 to 73, we have been discussing about the fundamentals, about the cables. We have been discussing the basic components and their functions. Then we have discussed how to analyze a cable without stiffening girder. When the supports are at the same level, when the supports are at different levels, and what is the designer's expectation. But as a student, examiner may give some data, you will be asked to find out some other data. In those cases, how to tackle different types of problems. In the case of cables, supported at the same level and also supported at different levels. We have discussed many different types of problems. I think that will be enough by referring to any textbook, one can easily understand any problem that is given, right? And also we have discussed one problem on cables subjected to concentrated loads. Suppose the loading is symmetrical, it will be maintaining a symmetrical deformed shape consisting of straight segments. Suppose if it is not symmetrical, then that will also maintain unsymmetrical shape. And we have also discussed one problem on a cable subjected to a uniformly distributed load and two concentrated loads of different values, so that the cable will not maintain a symmetric parabolic shape. Right. Now that we have discussed. So of course we have discussed almost all types of problems on cables without stiffening girders. We have discussed all problems without stiffening girders only. Right. Now before completing cables without stiffening girder, there is one more small topic and one more small definition to complete. One is regarding cables subjected to change in temperature. It is quite common because suspension cables are in open place, it will be subjected to varying temperature. In some places it is minus to plus. They may be subjected to reduction in temperature or rise in temperature. The reduction may go to minus also. It is obvious that the cables will be subjected to change in temperature. When a cable is subjected to change in temperature, the supports at a fixed distance L, that we cannot change. L we cannot change. 250 meters means 250 meters. 500 meters means 500 meters. That will not change supports. Therefore, when it is subjected to increase in temperature, there will be an increase in the length of the cable. So when there is increase in the length of the cable, the sagging will increase, the dip will increase. Suppose when the cable is subjected to a fall in temperature, there will be a shortening of the length of the cable. So that means the dip will reduce. When the dip increases, the horizontal tension will decrease. When the dip decreases 15 meters to 14.9 meters, naturally, when the dip decreases, the tension decreases. Tension will increase, right? So we are not going to do the elaborate derivation. There are two simple formulas. By simple differentiation, you can easily find out. Any book will give you. I'll just discuss only the formulas and application. So dou d by the change in dip of the cable. Subjected to rise, this will be increase. When it is subjected to fall, the dip will decrease. Right. So the formula is 3 L square by 16 D into alpha into T, where alpha is the, L is the span, D is the dip, alpha is the coefficient of linear expansion of the material of the cable, and T is the temperature. So that is the change in. So when there is increase in the dip, the horizontal tension will decrease, and vice versa, right? The change in the horizontal tension will be equal to, this is of course only due to the change in temperature. So 3L square into alpha T into H by 16D square. So this is the simple formula for the change in the change in the dip of the cable and the change in the tension in the cable. Or change the horizontal tension at the supports, right? So simple problems, we'll discuss one problem, only one problem. I'll read the problem and write down the data. The problem is a suspension cable of span 110 meters. So L equal to 110 meters, L equal to 110 meters, and dip 10 meters, D equal to 10 meters, D equal to 10 meters, is subjected to a rise in temperature of 28 degrees centigrade. So the temperature equal to 28 degrees centigrade. Rise in temperature is 28 degrees centigrade. Find the increase in the dip of the cable. That is, what is the value of delta D? This is the first question. Change in the increase in the dip of the, because it is subjected to rise in temperature, so there will be increase in the length, therefore there will be an increase in the dip of the cable. What is the increase in the depth of the cable? Right, that is the first part of the question. Second part is taking coefficient, of course that is required for the first part also, taking the coefficient of linear expansion of the cable material, that is alpha equal to 12 into 10 power minus 6 per degree centigrade. This is the coefficient of linear expansion. Take the value of alpha as 12 into 10 power minus, because that is required for change in the dip also. Here also it is required. Alpha is needed here. Right. Also find the change in the horizontal tension. Also find the change in the horizontal tension, namely delta H is also required. Delta H is also required. If the cable carries a uniform load of 30 kN per meter. If the cable carries a load of P equal to 30 kN per meter. That is the question. What is the, it is subjected to a rise in temperature. Rise in temperature. So what is the change in the dip of the cable? What is the change in the horizontal tension of the cable? It is subjected to a rise in temperature, and also it carries a UDL of 30 kN per meter. Right. Now, we need not do separate. Right. Now, coming to this formula. Now here itself we can substitute. The first requirement is change in the dip of the cable. So we know delta D equal to 3 into L is 110 meters, D is 10 meters. So L is 110 square by 16 into D equal to 10 meters into alpha is 12 into alpha equal to 12 into 10 power minus 6. Alpha equal to 12 into 10 power minus 6 into T is 28. Mere substitution. 3 L square by 16 D. Alpha is 12 into 10 power minus 6 into 28, that will give you the change in the dip equal to 0.076 meters. So equal to 0.076 meters. So this is delta D. This is the first part of the problem, that is a change in the dip of the cable. What is a change in the horizontal tension? For getting the change in the horizontal tension delta H, L is given, alpha is given, T is given, these values are readily available. H is not available. The value H is not available, for which the value of P is given. So the cable is supported at the same level. Same level. Therefore, when the cable is supported the same level, we know H equal to P L squared by 8D. P L squared by 8D, P is 30, P is 30, L is 110, P L squared by 8 into 10. So this is the value of the horizontal tension. That value equal to 4537.5. 45. So this is the second part of the problem. 4537.5. H equal to 45. Therefore, this is equal to 3. L is 110. L square by 16 D square. 16 D is 10. So D square is 10 square. 16 into 10 square into alpha. Alpha equal to 12 into 10 power minus 6. Temperature is 28. Alpha into H. H is equal to 4537.5. 4537.5. And that value equal to 34.5, minus 34.5, 9 kilometer. Minus. So delta H equal to minus 34.59 kilonewton. So this is the reduction in the tension that we have to mention, because when there is a change in the increase in the temperature, there will be increase in the length of the cable. Therefore, there will be increase in the depth of the cable. When the dip decreases, when the dip increases, naturally the tension will decrease. Therefore, you have to put with minus sign. Therefore, delta H equal to minus 34. So, this is another simple topic that we have not discussed earlier. So, this is about cables subjected to a change in temperature. It may be increase in the temperature or decrease in the temperature. So, this is one small topic. And one more small topic that needs to be discussed is, because I will not give the equation, when the cable is subjected to a uniformly distributed load throughout the span, we know that the cable assumes a parabolic shape. When the cable is subjected to uniformly distributed load, the cable assumes the shape of a parabola. Suppose there is no load. The cable is subjected to only its own weight. So when the cable is subjected to its own weight, the cable will not assume a parabolic shape. It will assume the shape of a catenary. Sometimes in a short answer question or in some interviews or in some competitive examination, this will be asked. When the cable is subjected to its own weight, self-weight, not subject to any external load, what is the shape of the cable? The cable will assume the shape of a catenary, for which you have to refer any of the books and get the equation. So this is another small point that needs to be discussed. Catenary, right? Now, in the case of cables, so far we have discussed cables without stiffening girder. Of course, before taking up the cables with the stiffening girder, we have not discussed about the supporting structure and also the anchor cable. Supporting structure and anchor cable. So there are two types of supports. There are two types of supports. One is, this is a supporting tower or pylon. The supporting tower or pylon is a tall structure, the height varying from 20 meters to sometimes 200 meters. So this is the supporting tower. Now, the type of support that is provided on the top may be a pulley, a pulley type of support. This is one type of support. This is a pulley or guide pulley. You can say pulley. This is the suspension cable. This is the anchor cable. The anchor cable will be connected to a rock or huge mass of concrete. This angle will be different. 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 So this is theta for the suspension cable. This is theta for the anchor cable. So this is the suspension cable. So this is the tension in the suspension cable. This is tension in the anchor cable. Tension in the suspension cable. Tension in the anchor cable. These angles will be different. So because this span may be very large span, maybe 200 meters, 500 meters, 2 kilometers, 2 kilometers, that depends upon the span of the bridge. So this angle will be different. Coming to this, it will be a straight cable because it is anchored to a huge mass of concrete or a rock mass. So this theta A may be different. Theta S and theta may maybe be different. So this is a pulley type of support. This is one way of passing the cable over the supporting tower. So in this case, what is the tension in the anchor cable? What is the vertical force to which the supporting tower is to be designed? What is the bending moment to which the bottom of the tower is to be designed? So that is one part of the problem. Right, let us first complete this before discussing the next type of support. Let us complete this. Now, when it is a pulley support, you know the property of a pulley. Because suppose you want to lift some weight. See, this is the pulley means the weight may be in the vertical direction. You may be pulling at some angle. At some angle you may be pulling. This may be vertical. This may be at some other angle. The property, so the pulley is used, say, for lifting. For example, let us say this pulley is used for lifting the weight. Naturally, it will roll along the direction where the force is more. Naturally, when you apply more force here, this load will get lifted. Or the property that I want to convey here is, this pulley will be in equilibrium only when the tension in the suspension cable and the tension in the anchor cable are equal. Then only the pulley will be under equilibrium. Otherwise, it will move, it will rotate in the direction where the force is more. Therefore, if this pulley is to be under equilibrium, this tension in the suspension cable and the tension in the anchor cable will have to be equal. Otherwise, it will not be under equilibrium. Of course, in the case of suspension bridges, this is not provided for the purpose of rotating. It has to be under equilibrium. So equilibrium means the tension in the suspension cable must be equal to tension in the anchor cable. Whatever may be the angle, the tension, the both tensions will have to be same irrespective of the angle theta A and theta S. So that is the, if this basic property is understood, whatever may be the given data, we can solve the problem. What is to be understood is only this. So the tension in the suspension cable and the tension in the anchor cable will have to be equal. Right. So that is one problem. Another, what is the vertical pressure? The vertical pressure here will be, so due to this, Let us call this as theta 1. Let us call this as theta 2. Theta. So, with respect to horizontal, the angle may be given. With respect to vertical, the angle theta s we can find out. Already we know how to find out the value of theta s or theta. That is not a problem. Right. Right. Now, to find out the vertical pressure, so the first property is the tension in the anchor cable will be equal to the tension in the suspension cable. The tension in the suspension cable, we have so far discussed number of problems, whatever may be the given span, dip, loading, etc. We will be able to find out the tension in the suspension cable. That's what we have discussed so far. That is known. That is known. Not only tension in the suspension cable, the horizontal tension we know, the vertical pressure we know, everything we know. Already we have discussed determination of these values only. Right. So the tension in the anchor cable will have to be equal to the tension in the suspension. That is one property that is to be satisfied for the equilibrium of the pulley type of support. Right. Next, what is the vertical pressure on the supporting tower? Vertical pressure. If this angle is known, we can find out this angle. Now this will cause vertical pressure VA. Suppose this is support A. Support A, this is VA. Now due to this, we know the value of VA. We can find out. We can find out the value of VA. If the span is known, dip is known, load is known, we can find out the value of VA. So from the suspension cable, this VA will be known. Now this VA will be acting in the vertical direction of the supporting tower. The vertical, so this is VA, that is due to the suspension cable. This is the value of VA plus the vertical component of this TA plus TA into cos theta 2. TA into cos theta 2. VA plus TA into cos. Or if theta is given with respect to horizontal, theta is given with respect to the horizontal, we can say R VA, that is from the suspension cable, plus the tension in the anchor cable into this value is available. So this means for getting the vertical component into sin theta A, TA into sin theta A. So we need not worry about the formula with respect to the vertical. If the angle is given, into cos theta 2, or the angle is given with respect to horizontal, we can say sin theta A. Suppose if there is any confusion in cos theta, sin theta. Suppose this is given as 30 degrees. This is 60 degrees. That's all. Cos 60 degrees. That's all. TA into cos 60 degrees. So mark the angle with vertical also and find out the value. So this is about the vertical pressure on the supporting tower. This is one. Similarly, the height of the tower will be given. So they may give you the height of the tower. What is the bending moment to which the bottom of the tower will be subjected to? That is, the horizontal tension here, this is already known to us. H is known to us. H is equal to PL square by 8D or PL square by 2D1. That is in the suspension cable, we know how to find out the value of. So let us say the horizontal component is, say, in this direction, right? Actually, in the cable, it will be in the opposite direction. It will be in the opposite direction. And on the supporting tower, if this is to the right, so this you know how to find out. Then here, this we have to resolve in the horizontal direction. So this is the H in the anchor cable. H in the anchor cable equal to T in the anchor cable into cos theta A. Equal to minus, one is towards right, the other one is towards left. This is TA into cos theta A. This is the opposite. So equal to the horizontal force on the top of the tower. The horizontal force on the top of the tower, that will be different because theta A and theta S are different. That will be different. Only thing is, TA will not be equal to TS. That is a condition to be satisfied. So equal to that is the horizontal tension of the top of the tower equal to h minus ta into cos theta a. If that is known, if we can find out the value of ht into, let us say small h into the height of the tower, because this will be the net horizontal force acting on the top of the tower, that into the height of the tower. So this ht into h will be the bending moment. So the base of the tower, the base of the tower, when the cable passes over a pulley type of support, then the vertical pressure to which the tower is to be designed is this value, and the horizontal tension is this value into h will give you the bending moment. So the bottom of the tower will have to be designed for a vertical force and also a bending moment, subjected to axial force and a bending moment. So this is about a cable passing over a pulley type of support. The other type of support, same tower, varying from 20 meters to sometimes 200 meters. Here, the second type of support is saddle. So this is pulley type of support. This is pulley support. So this is a saddle. A saddle will be placed on rollers. A saddle plate will be placed on rollers. The saddle may be like this, or the saddle placed on rollers may be like this. So here you'll have the suspension cable, and here you'll have the anchor cable, right? So here, this is the suspension cable. This is the tension in the suspension cable. This is the anchor cable. This is the tension in the anchor cable. Now, because the anchor span, suppose if this is 100 meters, this will be 30 to 40% of 100 meters. So this will be, if this span is 100 meters, this will be 30 meters to 40 meters. The anchor, anchor span. This is suspension span, that is anchor span. 30 to 40% of the, right. Now we will concentrate the next type of support, namely the saddle placed on rollers. The saddle may be like this or may be like this, no problem, right? So this is the, with respect to vertical, let us say this is theta s. With respect to horizontal, we call it as theta a, no problem, anything, theta s and theta a. Now when it is placed on the rollers, the saddle should not move in the horizontal direction. It has to maintain equilibrium. Therefore, if you don't want a horizontal movement, the condition to be satisfied is that horizontal component of tension in the suspension cable, the horizontal component of tension in the anchor cable must be equal. If they are equal, there will be no horizontal movement. It is placed on rollers. If the force towards right is more, it will move towards right. The force, because it is placed on rollers. So the main point to be understood is that the horizontal component of the tension in the suspension cable and the horizontal component of tension in the anchor cable will have to be equal. So this is the horizontal component of tension in the suspension cable. This is the horizontal component of tension in the anchor cable. This is the suspension cable, and that is the anchor cable. HS and HA must be equal. Now this already we know. So we have already got the value of the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension towards left in the cable, and on the supporting tower it will be towards right. So this is the horizontal component of tension in the suspension cable on the supporting tower. Now this is the tension, Suppose if this value is theta A, the horizontal component HA equal to TA, TA, this is with the horizontal, therefore cos theta A. The main condition to be satisfied is the horizontal component of both tensions must be equal. If that is equal, then right. Now, coming to the vertical pressure for which you have to design the supporting tower. So, this is from the suspension cable, it is VA or VB. This is support A, it is VA, because in the cable, it will be in the upward direction. On the supporting tower, it will be a vertical downward force. So, it has to be designed for a vertical force of VA from the suspension cable, that already we know the value, plus V anchor cable. I mean, anchor cable, this is TA, into sin theta A. Or we can find out this value. This value equal to 90 minus theta A. So cos 90 minus theta A. That will give you the vertical component. Vertical component equal to the vertical component of the tension from the suspension cable plus vertical component of the tension in the anchor cable. That will give you the vertical force. Now coming to the bending moment, when it is placed on the rollers, the condition is that this horizontal component and this horizontal component will be equal. It must be equal. Therefore, the net horizontal force on the top of the tower equal to zero. So, when the net horizontal force on the top of the tower equal to zero, the tower will not be subjected to any bending moment. The base of the tower, because there is no net horizontal force. Therefore, it will be subjected to only vertical force and no bending moment here. That is about the cable passing over a saddle placed on rollers. So, this is about the types of supports. Right. Now, with this, we will take up a numerical problem and we will go fast. Because once if the concept is understood, solving a numerical problem will not be a matter. A suspension cable of span 180 meters, that is L equal to 180 meters. Has the supports at the same level. Right. It carries a uniformly distributed load of 30 kilonewton per meter. So P equal to 30 kilonewton per meter over the entire span. The dip of the cable is 16.5 meters. Right. And the slope of the anchor cable at the top of the tower is 35 degrees with the horizontal. So this value is given as 35 degrees theta anchor cable equal to 35 degrees with horizontal. 35 degrees with the horizontal. Determine the horizontal and vertical reactions. Horizontal and vertical reactions on the top of the towers. On the top of the tower. What is the horizontal component of the force? H top of the tower, vertical force on the top of the tower. What are these values? What are the horizontal and the vertical component of the tower? Forces on the top of the towers. One. If the cable passes over a frictionless pulley. Two. If the cable passes over a saddle placed on rollers. So that is the question. Now, can very easily understand. That's about the data. The first part of the problem is when the cable passes over a pulley type of support. This is a supporting cover. Now this is the suspension cable. This is the anchor cable. This is the anchor cable. This is the suspension cable. Suspension cable. TS. TA. Now here, for the anchor cable, the angle is given. This is theta A. It is given with respect to horizontal equal to 35 degrees. 35 degrees with the horizontal. 35 degrees with the horizontal. Now it is a cable supported at the same level. L is given, D is given, UDL is given. All values are given, right? So L is given as 180 meters, D is given as 16.5 meters, P is given as 30 kilometer per meter. Supports are at the same level. A and B are at the same level. So that is about the data for the cable and the loading that is given, right? Now what is the vertical force on the top of the tower? And what is the horizontal force on the top of the tower? What is VT? What is HT? That is the requirement. Right. Now coming to this, we know this is equal to VA. From the suspension cable, you can straight away take the value of VA. So we need not because we know the basics. So VA, now here, VA equal to PL by 2, because it is at the same level, supports are the same level, VA equal to VB equal to PL by 2. So P is given, P is 30 kilonewton per meter, L is 180 meters by 2. So this value is known. Then the horizontal tension, HE equal to P L square by 8D, when the supports are the same level, equal to P is 30, L is 180 square by 8 into D equal to 16.5. Therefore, these values you can easily find out because support the same level. Now, the horizontal tension, HE equal to VA equal to VA or VB equal to 2700. VA equal to VB equal to PL by 2. 30 into 180 by 2 equal to 2700. So PL square by 8D, HE equal to 7363.6. So this is the horizontal tension, 7363.6. Now we know T max equal to root of V square plus H square. T max equal to, both sides it will be equal because supports are at the same level, so root of V square plus H square. V is known, H is known. Root of V square plus H square, T max equal to 78. T max equal to 78. So you can just, I have not written in order, you can write, because V I have written here, I have written the answer here, H I have written here, answer here. And T max equal to root of V square plus H square. You have to substitute the value and show the calculations in a particular sequence. It is not in a particular sequence, so that you can set right. You can just write it in an orderly manner. This is not correct. Right. So these are the values. these are the values. So that's about the say value of T max V A V B and the horizontal tension for the suspension cable. Now these values you know how to find out, right? Now those values we want for our calculations, right? Now here we know the tension in the suspension cable will not be equal to the tension in the anchor cable. Tension in the anchor cable. The tension in the suspension cable is 7843 kilonewton. 78. So TS equal to mean TS equal to T. TS is 7843. TS is 7843. Equal to TA. So TA equal to TA equal to 7843. So in the case when the cable passes over a pulley type of support, we know the tension in the suspension cable and the tension in the anchor cable must be equal because the pulley has to be under equilibrium. Whatever may be the value of theta S, whatever may be the value of theta A, only when the two tensions are equal, the pulley will be under equilibrium, irrespective of the value of theta S and theta A. That is the important point that is to be remembered. Otherwise, it is not difficult. So, TS equal to TA. So, the tension, the anchor cable, we have got it. Right. Now, what is the vertical force? Vertical force here is the vertical component of the tension in the suspension cable is VA, that is VA, plus this TA into, when this is 35, you can find out this value. This value equal to 55 plus 55, 90, right? So 55 degrees you can find out. Either you can do the calculation with respect to this value or you can just find out 90 minus this value. So you want the vertical component. For vertical component, you make use of this angle. So TA into cos 55 into cos 55. Therefore, the vertical force on the top of the tower equal to VA. VA is 2700. VA is 2700 plus TA. TA is 7843. So TA is 7843 into cos of its angle with the vertical. Cos of its angle is vertical is 55, therefore cos 55 degrees. So this is equal to the vertical pressure on the top of the tower equal to 7198.6 0.6 kilonewton. So this is one value. One value is 7198. So this value equal to 7198.6 kilonewton. That is the vertical pressure. Due to this, it is a vertical reaction VA or VB. Due to this, tension in the anchor cable into cos 55, the sum will give you the vertical pressure equal to 7198.6. So that is one value. Next value, what is the horizontal tension? Horizontal tension, already I told you that this is due to the suspension cable. That is, here it will act as a tension in the opposite direction and the supporting tower it will be acting towards right. Now this value is already known to us, H equal to 7363.6. So this is the horizontal component of tension in the suspension cable, which already we have got it using PL square by 8D. Now the horizontal component of tension in the anchor cable will be acting towards left. This value equal to TA into cos of its angle with the horizontal, that is equal to TA into cos 35 degrees. TA into cos 35 degrees. So that difference you have to find out. So the horizontal pressure on the top of the tower equal to the right, it is 7363.6. That is in the suspension cable. In the anchor cable, so this is towards right. In the anchor cable, towards left, TA equal to 7843. TA equal to 7843 into cos of its angle with the horizontal, cos 35 degrees. So this is towards left. So that will be equal to, that value equal to 939 kilonewton. 939. HT equal to 939 kilonewtons. So that will be the horizontal tension. Suppose if the height is known, you can find out the axial force and the bending moment at the bottom. That we can find. So that is the vertical and horizontal components of the force on the supporting tower when the cable passes over a pulley type of support. One more thing is that when the cable passes over a saddle placed on rollers, what to do? That is, you know, for when the cable is passing over a saddle placed on rollers, we know the first condition is the horizontal component of tensions must be equal. Horizontal component of tension in the suspension cable must be equal to horizontal component of tension in the anchor cable. Therefore, the net horizontal force on the top of the tower is equal to HS towards right minus HA towards left must be zero. Otherwise, the rollers will not be under equilibrium. It will start moving in the direction where the force is more. If the roller has to be under equilibrium, the horizontal component of forces must be equal. Right. For the suspension cable, we know the horizontal tension. The horizontal tension is given by 7363.6 is the value of H for the suspension cable. This already we know. Minus HA equal to TA into cos 35 degrees. Now here the value of this is given as 35 degrees. We can find out this value. This value is 90 minus 35 equal to 55 degrees. So in this problem it is given. So the angle is given as 35 degrees with the horizontal. So TA into cos 35 degrees. So this is towards right, this is towards left. Must be equal. Or this is equal to 0. That will give you theta, this we can find out. So TA will be the only unknown. So this will give you the value of TA. So in the earlier case, the tension in the suspension cable and the tension in the anchor cable was equal. Now here it is different. So the tension in the anchor cable in the second type of problem is, so 7363.6 by cos 35 degrees, that is equal to 89.3 kilonewton. This is, so here HT equal to 0. The horizontal component, it is required, that is equal to 0. This is a basic condition when the saddle is placed on rollers. HT equal to 0. So only V vertical component. Vertical component equal to VA plus TA into sin theta A. TA, we need not worry about the formulas theta A or sin theta A, cos theta A. So here the vertical pressure on the supporting tower, vertical pressure on the top of the tower equal to VA, V or VA or VB, VA plus the tension in the anchor cable into cos 55 degrees into, either you can say sin 35 or cos 55, whichever is convenient. Formula is not important, right? Cos of its angle with the vertical. So VA, we know V equal to some 2700, already we have got the value 2700 plus TA, just now we have got the value 89.3 into cos 55 into 55 degrees. So that is equal to 7856. Therefore, in the second case, this is equal to 7856 kilonewton, and this value equal to 0. When the cable passes over a saddle placed on rollers, the net horizontal force equal to 0, otherwise the saddle will not be under equilibrium. So this is how we will have to find out the tension in the anchor cable, both in the case of a cable passing over a pulley type of support or passing over a saddle type of support, the vertical pressure on the top of the tower, and also the moment to which the tower is subjected to. So when the cable passes over a saddle placed on rollers, the moment is equal to 0 because the horizontal component of tension become equal. Therefore, net horizontal force equal to 0, the base of the tower will not be subjected to any bending moment. So this is how you have to find out the different forces when the cable passes over a pulley type of support or a saddle placed on rollers. That completes the suspension cables. We have completed only cables without stiffening girders. So in the subsequent classes, we will take up what happens when the cables are supported by stiffening girders. So that will take up in the next lecture. So this completes cables without stiffening girder. Thank you.